Alright then, you have some proof that the rocket, LEGO rocket that I'm using exists. It's from LEGO Overwatch. I know, it's not Creator. So, here's the front. Here's the back. Alright, easy stuff, get over. Alright, let's open this. Here's Mag 5. Here's tiny big one. I'm going to play. Oh, big one. Big one. A bag of special pieces. Ah, here's the Winston figure. And then this is bag 4. Another bag 1. Bag 3. We have a very nicely packed construction booklet set with the stickers. And lastly, bag 2. Here's the booklet set. That's book 2. Looks like. Here's book 1. Here's the stickers. Bag 1. Whoa! Alright, hello guys, this, you're staring at it, after you just saw a little montage of me unboxing this and building this. Well, you didn't really see the building, but mostly unboxing this. I finally managed to have time to do a video on this. And yeah, if you didn't know, I used to do LEGO reviews. Little Mark 45 used to do LEGO reviews. And the legacy still lives on, I guess, so I'm sorry for this terrible cringe, but this is a review, because I don't really do full-on reviews anymore. I just want to show you what's here and what's there, the figures and stuff, and my thoughts, because honestly, this is a pretty good set. And then later on, I have all the LEGO Overwatch sets I've gotten laid out here, and then I'll express my thoughts on it. But anyways, enough ranting, let's go on. So, yeah, as you can see, this is too big to fit in my old studio, so I gotta move this to a more open space area. So this is just a corner of my room, of my office, which you normally see my face cam videos in. So this is just at a corner, on a IKEA table. So IKEA, send the paycheck. And yeah, so it's big enough for me to fit the set without a roof that's covering it. And I'm actually kneeling as I speak right now, because I'm sitting on the floor and I have to lower the tripod so low. But anyways, this is the Watchpoint Gibraltar set. This is the biggest LEGO Overwatch set they have done, I guess. And so far in the first wave, this is around $120 in Canada. So this is a pretty big and expensive set, but believe me, I think the price ratio for this amount of stuff you get is, well, debatable. Alright, first things first, we got the actual set, which is the rocket and the pad, the launch station where it's launched in. And I'm sorry for the lighting, by the way, if you couldn't see it as well, because once again, it's not a proper studio setup, so I just have a light overdaying this. So anyways, here's the set, and before we look at everything in detail, here's what the full set looks like when the rocket is stationed. And the back obviously does not look as pretty as what you see on the front, because they don't expect you to look at the back, right? This is where all the dirty stuff is hidden. So going to this side and then back down here. And how do we detach the rocket from this place? Well, first things first, let's remove this hinge. So again, let's get this little drawbridge up here, and then we move that up. Then we take this, and then lift off! And then what you have left is this little rocket station thing, which we will look at first before I show you the actual rocket. Alright, let's start off from the bottom, first things first. This pad is actually where the payload ship from Tracer versus Widowmaker is supposed to go in here, charge here, and then parks and loads the stuff into the ship before the rocket ship takes off. Based off the game, this is the final checkpoint of the Watchpoint Gibraltar map, if you didn't know. And so, then moving on up here, we get this area, which is actually where the rocket parks. So these two little holes are where the rocket booster goes. So, you get the boosters here, and then they just sit like that. So it's very, very simple. There's no lock, there's no any mechanism to release the rocket. It's just a simple, you put it on, you take it off. And then, moving on here, we get the base of the tower. And then moving on up here. And up here we get the Overwatch sticker. And then, oh, it's a really tall tower, by the way. And then you got these little exhaust pipes. And then, got this little PA system, I think, a little speaker. Or satellite, I don't even, like, tell. I can't tell. Okay, so you guys can correct me, because I actually don't know. And then up here, we get the little bridge with that could fold up and down. Just as simple as that. And then, move this to the side for a better angle for you guys to see. You can, put a figure on top. For instance, I'm putting Reaper here. Just walk, and then he's fell to his death. And then down here, some very interesting pipe work here. And then here is just a long brick, red brick line. So that's a little bit sad, but oh well. And then. On the bridge though, actually, I think, yeah, you can't really fit any, like, figures though. However, these pillars are actually, like, minifigure scaled, as in, the bars here matches the hands of a figure, so you can just attach the figure, and then he can just climb up, just like that. So, it's very useful. There's no ladder. The minifigures just climb up, or in Pharaoh's case, she just flies up. But yeah, next up we got the actual rocket. This is a pretty big rocket, and according to research I found on the internet, this rocket can fit up to 18 minifigures, I think. So two in the cockpits, and then a bunch of them in the back, which I'll show in a sec. So, first things first, most very simple front seat cockpit with just switch or a steering wheel. And then back here, second cockpit, you just remove this, you can put a figure inside. And then what I don't really like about this rocket is the fact that these are just very loose. You can just snap off very easily, which I'm not gonna do, but the wings could have really improved, you know, Lego. You could really improve on this. And then here we get the thrusters, I guess, the rocket thrusters, if you will. And here's the side. Yeah. So, what's special about this ship is two really cool functions. First and foremost, if you lift this, oh, this is also where you can park the payload ship from Tracer versus Widowmaker onto here as well, which I will put it on the screen right now to show you guys. And then you can fold this open, or open this up, and open these two up. Then inside, you get a secret compartment where you can store a bunch of stuff. For instance, I'm going to put Winston's banana in here. There you go. And then maybe like a little med pack. Med pack here. Yeah, I can't forget Winston's banana smoothie. goes along with banana. Must have gone bananas. And then, I guess these are his exhaust pipes, but I know these are not how it's set up, but I just threw them in there, and yeah, 18 minifigures you can fit in here. Just dump them in or stuff. You can even put Winston here, but I'm not going to go through the whole process of taking everything off Winston and then putting them into the ship. So yeah, you can just imagine that for yourself. But let's close this back up. Although this one in particular, this hinge always gets stuck for some reason, and I have to forcefully close it. And then the main function of this ship is that it's a 2-in-1, so you can split this ship into two. All you gotta do is hold this, you pull it apart. So what you're left with is two very different and unique ships from the rocket ship. So, first things first, let's look at ship number one, which is the head of the ship. Which I don't really like it. Because you just get that one thruster, and this whole hollow section here makes it look really, really weird. And other than that, open the cockpit, and then you can flip this open. And then this is either a missile launcher or something, or it's like a little satellite. Maybe it could be both, I don't know. But I can't really tell, honestly. So you just put that in. Yeah, this is a plain old ship that I'm not a big fan of in the first place. And then it's the second part here. We have... This one looks a lot cooler, in my opinion, when you split this in half, because this is a cargo ship. You just simply flip this open, you can chuck a figure inside there, and then I already showed you this, the whole storage function. So I guess this ship functions as like a cargo ship, and then the other one's just, I don't know what the other one's is, because this is not a combat ship, if you didn't know. This is like a, you know, it's a payload ship. This is what the heroes are trying to escort the payload to the entire time. So I'm just gonna assemble this back together. Just like that. Just a simple snap. There you go. Alright, accessories and minifigures. First things first, came with a brand new brick separator and two extra ammo for Farah's gun. It's like rocket ammo, I guess. So that's very straightforward. And then this is a new brick separator. I've actually never gotten this brick separator before, so I always have I always got the orange ones. So getting a new one in like turquoise green, I don't even know what color this is, but this is a pretty cool color. It's the first time I got a brick separator in this color. Okay, now we're gonna look at the figures. And yes, Lego, I know you made this mistake. So if you're not aware of what the mistake is for Mercy, Lego's even ashamed of it to hide it in a box and cover it up. So you see, this is what her face is supposed to look like. You know, just like the game, everything. It looks, and then the hair is covering it up. But what you actually get in the actual figure, yeah, Lego, I'm exposing you, all right. All right, that's just disappointing. I'm aware, I've seen people on the internet rage about this face. Look at this. It's printed terribly. I am so disappointed with you, Lego. You should have known better than to make a mistake on a character from a video game. Tis. I mean, I'll forgive you if it's your own figure from your own series, but this is from a video game. It's from Overwatch. So, Lego, you really messed up on this figure on Mercy. But anyways, apart from her misprinted face, you get her healing staff, aka where she heals her heroes with, and then you got her wings. They're just the standard eagle wings. You can flap them, I guess. But yeah. Apart from the broken face, not my favorite figure. Absolutely hate it. Next, we have Farah, which I dropped, which is a lot better figure, obviously. And you can't really see her, but she has this, her rocket launcher that can shoot the rocket. We get her wings, where she boosts herself and does justice rains from above. And her helmet, you cannot see her face because the helmet's supposed to cover her face, but when you take it off, focus camera, there you go. It's her face under, just put the helmet back on. There you go, so that's Pharah. And then we have Reaper, which is, you know, who's my main hero in Overwatch. I use this guy pretty much all the time until Ashe came out, and then I started using Ashe more now. But here he is, he has his hood, he got his cape, and he got his two shotguns that every time he runs out of ammo, he just chucks them on the ground and picks up a new pair. And this is his wraith form, so his legs are just this ghost piece. But then they also include normal legs for him when he doesn't want to be in wraith form, because this is just one of his abilities. He's not wraith form the entire time, so I'm not gonna switch it. Winston, and he is so special that he gets his own mold, and this is no minifigure, alright? This is a big fig, and he gets his own special mold because he is that special. So face, just like the game, pretty standard. You got his glasses and everything. However, you can't move his legs. His legs are just stuck there, so he's gonna be forever like that. But you can pose the arms. You can make him like smash. You can also rotate the hands. You can go like, come join me, join Overwatch, and together we will destroy the Omnix. Okay, no, that is not what Winston sounds like. But then you can also do this. So when he's crawling, you know, just like a normal gorilla. And then you got his Tesla that shoots this thing, and then his booster when he like launches himself up. So yeah, nothing much after that for this figure. You can't even move the legs. That's what I'm not happy about. If only you could move his legs, and that'll make him a better figure. But then again, he is a special molded figure, so I won't complain much. I'm pretty happy with this figure. And he was really mainly the only reason I wanted this set in the first place. And yes, you can fold the Tesla if you're wondering. Alright, there you go. That was my review of this set. It's obviously not a full-on review. I'm not a professional LEGO reviewer like the other ones out there. I don't even know any good LEGO reviewers. I mean, I used to be a LEGO reviewer and I used to go into details and everything, but by now I just want to show you what this does and my thoughts on it. And I give this set on a scale of 5 a 3 out of 5. 1 point off because of Mercy's terrible face. That's already a point off. And 2 because that's it really. I feel like this set is lacking. They should include like one more vehicle for like Reaper or something, because Reaper is the only bad guy in the set actually. But it's just, you got the space station, you get the rocket, and you get a bunch of minifigures and Winston, who is a big fig. And that's it. All for $120. Like, I just feel like LEGO should add more to this set. This set needs a little more, just maybe one tiny vehicle for Reaper, that will already be good. So yeah, this set's a little lacking in terms of play. For displaying and collecting, this is a good set. You can put this is an excellent set to put up on display. But to really play with it as a little kid who wants to play with these kind of sets, I guess you can recreate the Watchpoint Gibraltar, you know, escort the payload mode in with LEGO, but you'll need Tracer versus Widowmaker's ship to do it. And so I feel like, yeah, it's lacking. This set is lacking. So 3 out of 5. And yeah. And I guess but other than that, this is a pretty good set. So next video I'll be putting up all the Overwatch sets, LEGO Overwatch sets that I've gotten, and then I'll do a full on, you know, I'll tell you some of my background of Overwatch and what I think of these sets in general. So that will come. And in the meantime, make sure to subscribe and smash a like button on this video if you enjoyed this quote-unquote mini review. And yeah, other than that, check out my other LEGO videos if you haven't already, where I just go unbox them and go over their play features and everything. So yeah, make sure to smash the like button, subscribe, and I will see you all in the next video. Ciao.